So again, these are some of the services we're going to be bringing through the rest of the year, starting with Empora Title, because I'm very excited to bring Empora Title. They started in Ohio. They're based out of Ohio, and they are who you're looking for fast, affordable, stressless closing. So let me introduce to you Mr. Online Title from Empora, Brett Schieber. Round of applause, please. Oh, we have a drawing?
Can you hear me, guys? All right. It's nice to meet you. My name is Brett. I'm from Empora Title. I want to tell you a little bit about us. I know title is boring and it's miserable, but I just want to tell you a little bit about why we got started and the value proposition that we found and the void in the marketplace that we found that brought us to where we are and why we're nationwide now. So a little bit about me. I'm Brett, obviously I'm from Empora Title. What brought me to Empora was I spoke with Megan, and Megan was working at a different company, and she was actually working for software for a title company that was kind of coming up with a process for Chicago Title, and she realized there was a huge void in the marketplace, and she realized that there's this slow, mundane process that people go through, and she figured that there was an easier way to do this process, especially for investors, right? So we wanted to figure out, what can we do to make the title process easier? And what we came up with was that we wanted to gear towards investors more. So what geared me towards that is I started out in commercial real estate. I went to Indiana University. I got my degree in finance, and I was in commercial real estate. And I loved it, but I wanted to be more involved in a startup company. And this is like a SaaS solution, so it's a software as a solution. And we took this process and built it into a title company. And we chose Empora because we realized that the process is so slow and takes so long that we thought to automate it to make it easier for everybody, the process would go much quicker. So I want to show you basically who Empora is, the features that we offer, some testimonials from the experts around the country that use us as investors, industry experts, and then how you would book a demo online and learn how to submit a property. So the title insurance is broken, right? So it's an archaic system. So typically you call up, you'd either email your rep that you're close to, or you would send it in. Maybe it would take 1 or 2 days for them to have eyeballs on your deal, right, before they would send it in the title. So what we do is when you go into the portal, you would submit your deal, it automatically kicks up to the county and sends it to the title service, right? So you have eyes on it and it automatically kicks it up. So that way you're not wasting any time from the time that you submit the deal to the time that it gets sent up to the county for the background check on the title. As far as the inconsistency, what we offer is continuity of service. So no matter how many deals that you send, you'll always have the same rep. So you get the same experience every single time you send in a deal, whether it's on a Tuesday in March or a Thursday in April, you'll always get the same deal and the same exact process, so you know how to scale your business. Expensive, because of our automation process, the part that is not nuanced, where you don't have to have eyeballs on, we've automated that process to save money. So we're less expensive as far as the title process because of the automation process, right? We like to think of ourselves as Amazon Prime. We created a faster way to get deals done. Now, title's still title. When you have a title search and things come up, it still needs to be taken care of. But all the human error, all the parts where it's sitting in email box or people aren't seeing it, we've taken care of that process to speed that up. So we are about 25% less expensive and we close about 20% faster. Right now we're in Ohio, Pennsylvania, Florida, Kentucky, and Indiana. So those are the states that we're going now, and we will be in North Carolina, Texas, Arizona, and I believe New Jersey coming up are the next states for our barrier to entry. Scalable. So we've made this process, it's mostly geared towards people that are wholesalers, assigners, doing joint ventures, creative financing, whether it's novation, subject twos, anything like that is what our been our main focus. So when you're trying to scale a business like a wholesale and you have 1, 2, 3, 5 deals, you can look at our dashboard and you can see all your deals in a row, you can see what deal is closing the fastest, all the way down to which closed deals is the furthest, you can see the roadblocks that are in the way of each deal, and you can see what needs to be taken care of. You can click on that deal, and it's almost like a tracker. You can see where your deal is in real time. You'll get automatic pins as your process progresses to the next stage, we always have live reps that have eyes on your deal that you can call up and speak to somebody. But if you don't want to talk to anybody, you can look on your dashboard and see when the deal starts. When it's finished, you can upload earnest money onto our account that's instantaneous. So we make it pretty much we try to make it as pain-free as possible for investors. Inconsistency, it's opaque, right? It's hard to know the status of the deal. So again, you have a deal tracker. You can hop in without calling anybody. You can see where the deal is at all times. And if you have any questions about that process, you can call up and speak to a rep. And because of all this process, you save about 15 to 25% on each deal, just because we're not passing that cost on to you, and we're not keeping that savings. What we hear from investors, so great communication is everything. As you guys know, in investors, the most important thing that I hear from pain points from investors, from real estate agents, to sellers that are only trying to sell their home for the first time is communication. Communication is huge. If there is no communication, there's a lack of trust, and typically things get screwed up and deals fall through all the time. The wholesaling business, the assigning business as a whole is volatile, right? There's about a 25% cancellation rate. However, what we are trying to build is also like a marketplace. So we have a unique clientele list, and we have a lot of investors that do deals. So instead of having a cancellation, we're trying to connect wholesalers with end buyers. So if you have an end buyer that falls out, we also have investors that we could hook you up with and link you up with to save money, because if you guys cancel and the deal's been going on for 3 weeks, we eat that cost. Yeah, we may charge $100, but that's a huge loss to us. So instead of having a deal cancel, we'll hook you up and we'll try to connect you with other end buyers to make sure that deal closes more quickly and easily for you. And we're trying to create a marketplace with the value add that we have with the investor list across the country that we've built up over time. And we do about anywhere from 150 to 300 closings a month right now. Move this down, and I'm sorry, they just created the sales deck for me, honestly. So what would it like to be? So this is what we're doing and what's coming on. So submitting earnest money, right? Submitting earnest money via Venmo. No more wire fees. Close from your couch or office 100% of the time. You can set KPIs, you know, for your title partner and have them self-report. Be the first to know about exclusive off-market data trends, right? So we'll be able to tell you in your market what's going on, what trends are happening, and what zip codes. So that way you know where to market. And like I said, as far as closing, you can do a remote online. We can send mobile notaries anywhere across the country as well. So that's typically how we do our closings with investors and for sellers. Sometimes they like to meet at a bank or they don't want to go to their house. We'll meet them anywhere across the country. Let's see here. This is a testimonial from Empora. So he does, Nick, his company is ProCash Buyers. He does about 25 to 30 deals a month, I would say. He said, working with Empora is like adding a team member to our company. Their portal brought transparency to the title with all our deals, documents, and title info in one place. It makes seamless transaction for every party involved. Also, for tax purposes, every deal that you have that you close with us stays on file. So if you need to click on that for tax purposes, we have every deal that you've closed, and you can get any entity or any doc saved on file on your dashboard just by putting in your username as well. You never have to give us information twice. When you submit the deal, you don't have to enter in the deal information. We'll have it so when you enter in the deal, it will automatically, with our AI, populate the name, your company, your LLC, and all that information, and it will input it. So you'll never have to enter it twice. Unless you're using a different LLC every single time, you'll just have to submit the deal, and it will automatically kick to the county. You'll get an email via email and your deal message to let you know that your deal has been sent to the county for title search. And our deal messaging is such that regardless of where you email us back, you can text message us, or you can do it on the deal message on our dashboard. It will all show up in chronological order in one stream. So your messaging will live in one space like a text message. So you can respond from an email or a text, and it will all show up in one space. So if you have a partner or you just forgot to answer a question, it will always live there, and you'll always be able to get that communication. So you know where your deal is at all times. Again, communication is key. And if you don't know where your deal is, or you felt like you have to keep giving the same information twice, or a title company doesn't know how to do subject to's, or they don't know how to do novations, or they're not good with assignments, and they may give the wrong information to the wrong party, that kills deals. So every party knows what's pertinent to their deal. And that's where we become experts in, and that's where we are well-versed. We typically don't deal with one-offs where there's a realtor and they're selling their home to a first-time homeowner. They typically wouldn't use Empora because this is geared towards more wholesalers, assigners, investment companies that are looking to scale their business in a way that makes sense, where everything can live in one place to make life easier for them, for their TC, their transaction coordinator, their partners, their legal team, whoever needs to see that. We have wholesalers that do 2 to 3 deals a month and anywhere from 50 to 65 deals a month. So that's where we really geared. We're not gonna be able to beat out Chicago Title, where they have a bunch of real estate agents that send in one deal to somebody that's buying a first-time homeowner. That's typically not where the value add is. Again, our business and our dashboard and our platform allows you to scale more easily. And that's where you also save money. I believe we've saved our clients typically anywhere from like $5,000 to $15,000 a year on deal just by saving money on title costs as well. Let's see here. This is a little bit about, can't probably see that well. This is a little bit about Megan, our partner. So she got the Forbes list 30 under 30. So when we went for our, we came up with an idea and we got financing from venture capitalists. We got $25 million in Series A financing, which is one of the largest in Ohio, because they believed in what we could do and how we can scale it. We started off in Columbus. I'm in Cleveland. We moved to Cleveland and I was focused on like the Cleveland Toledo market. We're breaking in Toledo and basically Northeast Ohio. And we broke into other states where we have found there's been a lot of investment. In Toledo, there seems to be a lot of deals, a lot of going on in Toledo. So that's where we wanted to start to scale up there towards Michigan. And we're going to be going into Michigan next month as well. So Megan was 30 under 30 in finance. The Columbus, Ohio startup aimed to speed up the increase in transparency of the often opaque title clearing process that is required for every real estate transaction in America. Its technology digitizes each step for real estate investors. It's hard to get the concept without being able to see a demo, but the way I want to explain it to you is this. You have a deal, you'll go onto our website. We also offer transparency as far as cost. We have a free cost calculator. So if you wanted to see what your title would cost before even entering anything, we have a cost calculator. You would enter in the state, you would enter in the price, whether it's finance or whether it's cash, and you'll get a preliminary fixed cost of what your cost would be before you even submitted the deal. So we just want to be transparent that we save money and you can see the cost, barring anything like there has to be some type of, obviously, if there's something that has to be done extra, that would be more, but you'll know. But these are preliminary fixed costs that are with every title company. So you'll know, give or take 5 or 10% what your deal will be before you submit it to us. On our website at emporatitle.com, you would just hit the cost calculator function. Do you guys have any questions for me? I just wanted to give you kind of like what it looks like to submit a deal. When you go to submit a deal, you would go on our website, you would create an account, or you would just click submit a deal. You would submit a deal, you would be able to upload the deal, you create a free login account. Automatically, it would show your deal on your dashboard. You'd be able to click in it. You would get an email right away from our reps within about 45 minutes saying that, hey, we have your deal, we're working on it, we sent it up for title. By then, you would have their email, their phone number if you wanted to speak to them. You'd be able to hop on your dashboard and see where the deal is. When you got title back, it would ping you or send you an email along with a deal message letting you know, hey, we got your title back. Here's what we found. You can pull up everything on your dashboard to see what's going on with that title. If you're a wholesaler, you can see that. Now, say you're a wholesaler and you have a buyer and you have a seller. Everybody can see the deal tracker, but they can only see what's pertinent to their part of the deal. So they see exactly what they need to see to get the deal done. From there, it'll ping you every step along the way. When earnest money is sent, you'll get a ping. When the deal funds or when it's recorded, it will ping you along the way so you know. Again, we pride ourselves on being able to answer a question within 45 minutes. So if you do want to talk to a rep, you leave them a voicemail, they'll get back to you within 45 minutes. And what's good is, like I said, continuity of service. You'll always have the same rep. So they'll become an expert in your business. Say you're doing 2 to 3 deals a month and you want to be able to trust the title company you're working with, well, they'll get to know you. If you're working with somebody that much, they'll know your business in and out, and not only will be their rep, but they'll also be able to help you get transactional funding. We offer offshoots, so So let's say we're a tool in your tool belt where we can offer transactional funding. We can offer end buyers if somebody falls through private money. We're also offering we're going to be offering, coming up soon, a platform where our buyers and sellers can post what they're selling, almost like a Facebook group, only our investors are vetted because you can see how many deals they're doing. So it's just another opportunity to not only be a title company, to also be almost like a power broker, where not only can you submit title, but you can get transactional funding. You can find an end buyer if one falls through, and if you have a deal and you don't have an end buyer yet, you can post it on our website, and somebody can look and see if they want it, and then they'll hook you guys up. You send us the purchase agreement, we take care of it. So our goal is to be like Costco, to be like Amazon, where you can find everything you need in one spot, to be more than a title company, to be more of a partner. So we're not sitting across the table from you, we're sitting on the same side. So that's what we strive to be. I feel like that's where we found our void in the marketplace, is by dealing with investors and learning on the fly the creative financing, because now with the market the way that it is, we see a ton of seller financing, we see a ton of novation, subject to's. Some we don't take, right? So if there's certain like power of attorney, certain things that we feel are at kosher, so to speak, we won't take them, but we'll let you know that. But we'll take usually 98% of deals that make sense and that obviously that follow the law. But we are well-versed in pretty much every deal you can find to make sure that your deal is taken care of, and it's basically, you just don't want a title company to screw up your deal. I feel like you shouldn't even really want to know us. You should be able to look on the dashboard, see who we are, basically see where your deal is, see if there's anything wrong with it, and if there is, we take care of it. And basically, I'm just trying to find that page. I'm trying to see if they offered me a demo. So I'm going to play this in the background for you guys.
Welcome to Empora Title.
This
getting
is a
your
quick
deal started
demo.
From our site is easy. Simply click login and log in using an existing account, or you can create a new account. Once you log in, you'll be brought to your deals page. If you don't have any deals, it'll look like this. If you have prior deals, it'll look like
I just want to make it larger for you.
Welcome to Empora Title. Getting your deal started from our site is easy. Simply click login and log in using an existing account, or you can create a new account. Once you log in, you'll be brought to your deals page. If you don't have any deals, it'll look like this. If you have prior deals, it'll look like this. Then you can click submit a new deal. First, we'll need the property address.
And that you don't need to do anymore.
Then we'll need to know your role on this deal, whether you're buying, selling, assigning, or refi. We'll need to know the information for everyone on your side of the deal. You can add additional party members to your side of the deal, such as a business partner or a spouse. Then you'll need to hit next. After that, we'll need the other side's information. We'll need their first and last name, an email address, or a phone number for them. Again, you can add any additional people to this side of the deal. Lastly, we'll need the purchase price. And you can upload any purchase contracts to the file. You can provide any other details that we need to know, such as parties' contact preferences, or if they need a translator, or any other information that you think is relevant for us to know before starting this deal. Once you submit your deal, you'll have the opportunity to go ahead and start the onboarding flows so that we can gather any additional information for this deal. You can also track and manage your deal from the deals page. You can add any additional team members to your side of the deal. You can also message your CSM directly to let them know any additional information you'd like.
And that's
you
a deal messaging.
Task for onboarding and for earnest money if it's applicable. And then, as always, you can go track and manage all of your deals directly from our portal. Thank you for choosing Empora Title. Let us know if you have any other questions.
So that page that you just saw, that's where you can manage your deals. Yeah.
Are you taking questions that?
Yeah, I just figured you would ask along the way, but go ahead. Yeah.
Okay. I really like what you were saying about having it like, what did you call it? Where the community where I can buy or subject to, you know, that's not up and running yet, did you say? If not, when do you think you'll have it?
So that should be opening up in the next probably 45 days. But what we do offer, let's say you have a subject to deal, right? And you're like, hey, this is my property. Do you have somebody in Toledo looking for this? You would send us the purchase contract, and we would CC you, we would send you the information for you to contact them, right? But for now, it's almost like a la carte. So until we're doing that, you'd be able to call us up, and per deal basis, we look at the deal and then send you end buyers that would meet accordingly to that subject to deal, correct? Until that's up and running, we're doing like an a la carte type of thing. But we do offer that now. It's just more of a one-off where you would call us up and say, hey, do you have anybody in this area that would be privy to this type of deal? I would look it up and I would CC you or send you their information, and then that would be up to you guys just to make that deal work.
And is there any cost involved with that?
No. So we don't charge any other cost for deals. It's straight title cost. So all the fees that we charge are just straight. It's just a typical title cost. There's no extra fees or anything like that. Okay. No.
And I know we have some new coming on investors that maybe they haven't made their first deal. What is it? Is there a typical or a range, a closing cost that they could expect to pay?
Yeah, so I would say, obviously, it depends on the purchase price. So let's say there's a purchase price of, just make it easy, $100,000. Let's say the house is $100,000 and it's a cash deal, right? Let's say, because typically wholesale assignments are cash. So you'd probably be looking at somewhere with a mobile notary. I would say, give or take, it would probably be somewhere like around, well, let me take a look here, watch. Let me see if we can do this in live if we have internet access.
Well, Empora Title, getting your deal started from our site is easy.
So you can pull that up. Let's see if I can do this live so I can give you an accurate answer.
Empora Title, getting your deal started from our site is easy. Simply click log.
Get out of here. Empora Title. Calculator. So let's say you wanted to do Ohio, purchase with financing, purchase with cash, and the sales price is $100,000. So the total cost would be $1,346, give or take. And you can see the breakdown of all the fees of what we charge. And that's with title insurance.
Oh, that's got it.
So that would be preliminary costs.
What's the other column, the 301? Oh, the seller.
Yes. Okay. And then it will break down the recording fee, obviously, that's levied by the state, deed prep, notary fee, commitment fee. And if there's zero, it's because we don't charge for it. We just state that. But you can look on here and see what the cost would be. You can opt not to have title insurance, right? That's your choice to have, but obviously as an insurance company, we offer title insurance. That's what we want you to do. However, it's not something that's mandatory clearly, but this is just a breakdown. So before you submitted something, you'd be able to come in here, take a look at it, and then you'd be able to compare it to anyone else and say, hey, what's the cost? And you gotta also remember when you're doing this, the value add not only is the price, but it's also self-serving, right? So we try to make it as simple as possible, and especially with assignments or just deals, you want to deal with a title company that's well-versed to be able to really navigate, because I can't tell you how many times we would have new people that really would not know what they're doing, and you'd really have to do a lot of hand-holding in the sense to really be able to do that. And I think it takes, where we found our niche is dealing with those new people, getting them to, Nick started out with two deals, and because he started to do it and get the hang of it, he grew into a large investor and a large wholesaler because he needed somebody in his tool belt not only to do his help him with his deals, but teach him also in a way that you're not giving legal advice, but to make sure they're not stepping on their own toes, right? So not only with the service, you're dealing with somebody that you can trust that you know that does these deals and know that we're not going to be a hindrance, we'll be a value add with that as well. And sometimes that cost, that doesn't come across in here. However, it's just a value add. It's like an, it's a currency that you can't see, right? It's a partnership. Yeah.
Another question is, it's really hard to read this screen. Can you just real quick mention the categories and the price? Just come on down the list there.
As I start, So for $100,000 for a cash, so owner's title insurance is $575. Lender's title insurance is obviously zero since it's cash. The settlement fee is $350. The search and exam is $100, which is the title search. There's no notary fee. The commitment fee is $50. The deed prep is $85. There are no junk fees, but you can just put that as zero. Transfer taxes, parcel transfer fee is zero. State conveyance fee is zero. County conveyance fee is zero, and then the recording fee is $186. And that's for the buy side. So for the sell side, would be $200 for the county conveyance fee. The state fee would be $100. The parcel transfer fee for the seller is $1. And that would be the only cost on that sell side, are those three things. The county conveyance fee, the state conveyance fee, and the parcel transfer fee of $1. Yes. So yeah, the deed prep and everything is included in here. That's $85 to the cost of the buyer and the seller. That costs nothing. Yeah. So we're just not passing that cost on, right? Because of the automation process, there's less people that we have to pay, so we don't have to charge nearly as much.
We have another question.
Yeah.
Are you planning on being at these meetings every month if we have questions that we want to ask you?
Yeah, so before I was traveling out of the state, we were members here. I just couldn't come because I was gearing us up in Florida, and I was in all the other states. But now that I'm back here, I'm originally from Cleveland. So I'll be coming here every month because we're going to re-sign RIA members, and then I'll be here every month just to give you guys guidance. And what I tell people, I think there's a ton of good title companies out here, especially if you have somebody that you trust that you're good with. We would never want to take away your business. What I would like to think of is an alternative, right? If they're busy or they got something going on, you can try us out as well. So that's what I like to think. I don't ever like to feel like it's this or that. I feel like there's multiple options and you should be able to make your choice based on that, right? So yeah, I'll be here every month just to answer any questions that you have on a case-by-case basis.
Where is your office located?
So our HQ is in Columbus on High Street. So that's where our headquarters is at. Yep. So we have about 75 people there. We have a small brick and mortar in Florida. But typically most people that are working on it are remote. And then we have the sales people that are across the states. But our HQ is in Columbus. That's where we started. That's where Megan's from as well.
I have a question. What percentage is the RIA discount?
That's a good question. I'd have to run that by Megan. But I'm sure we can come up with one for sure, because I think we're in every single RIA. So I think, like I said, if it's equitable, we definitely offer percentage because I think it makes sense. So yeah, I think, let me get that answer for you since I don't know it, but there will definitely be one and I'll get that to you for next month for sure. You guys have any more questions about title? I kind of wanted to not make this painful. Title is not sexy. It's not fun. There's nothing fun about it. What we want to do and we strive to be is just somebody that you don't really have to worry about. Like, you don't need to worry about title. And we're just trying to be an extra arm on the tool belt. And if there's any other tools in your tool belt that you don't have, we can assist with that too, as long as there's transactional funding. If you need an end buyer, there's a lot of property management we can offer that. So we've made partnerships with a lot of people that we don't have any stake in as far as money-wise, just reputation-wise. We're just trying to go the route of giving the best customer service possible and let our word of mouth speak for itself. And if you guys are on any of the Facebook groups in Cleveland, Ohio, you'll see Empora all over the place because we do a lot of deals there. And a lot of people give us shout-outs just because of the easy process, especially if you're doing more than one deal a month. Yeah.
Deal with all entities such as land trusts,
yes.
LLCs.
Yep, everything. Yep, and we do also, obviously, we do commercial too as well. So we're well-versed in commercial. Commercial is niche, but we do offer it as far as apartment buildings and things like that. So yeah, definitely. You guys have any other questions just about the title process or anything like
One
that?
One more.
Yeah.
So when you all sit around the table and go for the closing, if you're in Columbus, how does that work in Toledo when you have a, you know what I,
yeah, so it's just, we would send a mobile notary. Like, so we would send we would send a mobile notary out to, so you have a deal closing in Toledo, we have contracts all over the country, so we'd have a mobile notary in Toledo meet you for the closing. Or you could do it online. It's almost like a Zoom where you can do it online. A lot of people do prefer that. Some people that aren't used to that, like the old school way, don't like that. They want to see somebody. They want to touch the paperwork. We'll send a mobile notary out and do that as well. So those are what we offer. So we can do it. We do people that are out of the country all the time. They meet us. They'll go to the embassy, and we'll send it out there. We'll do online runs across the country all the time. So we just did one where some guy was in Israel, and we closed it. So
would you do it in a, like a dot loop format?
What's that, the closing?
Yes.
Yeah. That would be one way. That would be a format for closing, correct? Yeah.
So people are just meeting at a restaurant or something? McDonald's?
For the closing?
Yeah.
It really depends. Some people don't like someone coming to their home, so they can meet at a bank. At their local bank, if they choose to meet at their bank, they can really meet anywhere that they wanted to. We really leave it up to the either seller or buyer, wherever they feel comfortable that the mobile notary wants to meet, because not everybody wants people going to their homes.
So the bank is letting people just come in and use their lobby, or how do they do that?
Oh, for banks?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, so like typically like banks, it's just like doing a notary, right? So like we would go into a bank, and like people usually who choose banks choose their own bank. Right, so they'll go to a bank or the place that they're comfortable with. So typically, we've never had a problem. So a mobile notary will just go out, meet them at the bank, say, hey, we're meeting somebody here for a signing. So they do it for a number of different reasons, for trust, for different things like that. And this is just a closing for a house. So yeah, typically, bank is just one of the people where people feel safe.
Brett, people in Toledo are used to round table closings.
Yeah.
So a lot of the questions you're getting, because they're used to all, the buyer, the seller,
yeah,
agents, loan officers, everybody sitting at the same table at the same time.
Right.
And that's kind of a unique thing for Toledo. That's gone by the wayside in most other places.
Yeah.
So it's just a matter of a notary coming to you for you to sign the papers.
Yeah, and you could still have the round table if you choose. If all the parties are in one area, it would still be a round table. We would just have the mobile notary come out who was doing it to take care of it there too.
Yeah.
So it wouldn't be any different if that's the way all parties chose to do it. But in Florida or Cleveland, some people are like, hey, I'm over here, this person's over there, they just want to sign. So like, that's what we've got accustomed to, but we'll do it. Typically, it doesn't really matter to us. We're sending out the mobile notary if they want a round table and everyone wants to meet in one spot. We'll do that as well. In Columbus, they do come to the office. So all parties will come to the office because everybody likes coming to an office setting. It's just when you don't have brick and mortars all around the country, right? They'll do a round table and we can send a mobile notary out if you guys choose to meet at a restaurant. So it doesn't make a difference to us. We can meet you there and just send a mobile notary out there. You guys all choose the round table, the traditional setting, we can do that as well.
I think they're just not used to it being not necessary anymore. I've called closing Friday, and the buyers are in California, and the seller is here, and we are taking her to the title company, but only because that's where the notary is.
100%.
Now, if she's not feeling well because she is up there, we would just send the notary to our house.
Yeah, and that's no different from what we're doing. Yeah, so it's the same exact thing. And now with the conditions the way that they are, people find buyers all over the country, and there's a lot of people in California, Florida, Massachusetts that are buying properties, where it's just not feasible to have a round table. And you can have all the parties in one place if you choose, if that's something that's possible. If not, we still make it happen no matter what, because the point is just getting that deal closed and making everybody feel comfortable. So you let us know exactly what you want well into the process. So by the time that comes, everything's already ironed out and you know exactly what's going to happen during the close. So there'll be no surprises.
Some buyers and sellers should never sit across the table.
That's true. That is true. How do you guys feel the market now is in Toledo as far as what you guys are seeing in the last like 30 to 60 to 90? Are any of you guys like wholesalers, just investors in general? And what are you guys seeing in the marketplace as far as how things are going compared like to the last 6 months, just out of curiosity.
It's still a seller's market. It's loosening up some, and houses aren't going quite as fast. I am seeing some reductions in that, and that's from a real estate office's point of view. Anybody else? You're having trouble finding things out there? You're not seeing it. Your usual field to be picking on is seller selling their own home, and you just don't see that so much anymore.
And the sellers, they're valuing their house at a higher price, and the deals just aren't getting done because they're not realizing the correction. Is that typically what I'm seeing?
Yeah, you're not seeing the for sale by owners, and they might start a little higher, but they aren't letting them sit at that higher price because there is some demand. You know, you got five or six different offers. Even if they're not what you want, you're going to end up choosing one eventually.
Yeah, 100%. So that hasn't changed realistically. Yeah. Yeah, I'll be here every month, and I'll be able to answer questions that you have that's pertinent to certain deals. If you guys are wholesalers or just investors, I'll answer any questions that you guys have about certain deals or how things need to be done or what paperwork you guys need for those deals as well. All right, well, I don't want to take any more of your time up. I just wanted to introduce myself and tell you guys I'll be here every month, give you a quick synopsis on what we do. And if you have any questions, I can answer them one-on-one much easier on a case-by-case basis to dig into, to be more granular on the deals so it makes more sense on how this company and how we would affect you personally and the difference that we'll make. You'll get more out of that. But I appreciate your time. And thanks for coming. Thanks, Ann, for having me. I appreciate it.